हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड चैप्टर नंबर 2 डीसी पावर सप्लाईज। नाउ इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट ट्रांसड्यूसर। दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 3 फ्रॉम पेपर 1। सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय ट्रांसड्यूसर? ट्रांसड्यूसर is a device which converts one form of energy into another form, or it is a device which converts electrical quantity into non-electrical quantity, or vice versa, means non-electrical quantity into electrical quantity. Or we can say that an instrumentation system generally consists of major element. So an instrumentation system generally consists of following major elements. First one, an input device. Then second, a signal conditioning or processing device. Third, an output device. The input device receives the quantity under measurement and delivers a proportional electrical signal to signal conditioning device. And transducers are used as input devices. The signal conditioning device is used to amplify, filter, or otherwise modify the signal to a format acceptable to the output device. For example, different type of amplifiers, modulators, filters, analog to digital or digital to analog converters, etc. The output device may be simple indicating meter like DMM or panel meter, a magnetic tape recorder, a digital computer, or it may be CRO. Okay, students? Means it is necessary for instrumentation system, input device, signal conditioning or processing device, and output device. Now let us see what are the types of transducers. Transducer can be classified in two types: active transducers and passive transducer. Now let us see what is mean by active transducer. A transducer capable of producing electrical variations when stimulated by some physical form of energy, and which does not require external supply to perform its function. This is known as self-generating or active transducer, because it is capable of generating self-electrical signal or non-electrical signal without any external supply. So, active transducers are also called as self-generating. Why self-generating? Because this transducer does not require any external supply to convert one form of energy into another form, or to convert electrical signal into non-electrical, or vice versa. So remember that another name of active transducers are self-generating, as a self-generating transducers. Okay, students? Now let us see an example. A piezoelectric crystal generates an electrical potential difference across its opposite surfaces when mechanical pressure is developed across its other two surfaces. Means the crystal which generates electrical energy by means of pressure developed across its surface. Okay, so this is one of the best example of active transducer. Then thermocouple, photovoltaic cell, these are also example of active transducers. Now let us see second type of transducers, that is passive transducers. These transducers require external power to change in the electrical quantities like resistance, capacitance, etc. For example, a thermistor, it changes its resistance with temperature, but an electric supply is essential to produce the current variation in the circuit. Like capacitive microphone, LVDT means linear variable differential transducer, they need electric supply to perform their function. So these transducers are called externally powered or passive transducers. Means you have to remember that these passive transducers need external supply to convert one form of energy into another form. Okay students, this is keyword to remember the definition of passive transducers. Now this is a most important point. Question may be asked on this topic. What factors should be considered while selecting transducers? Means if we have to select transducer for conversion of energy, so we have to remember main factors while selecting the transducer, and following factors should be considered while selecting transducer. First factor is transducer type. This is very important point because we must know that which quantity is to be received by the system. According to this, we can think about the transducer type and the transducer group. For example, if we have lux meter is to be designed, then it becomes clear that photosensitive transducer must be selected for this application. After selecting the main group of transducer type, the proper and specific transducer can be easily selected by knowing operating range and processing technique. If we have to measure temperature, then it is necessary we have to select thermistor or thermocouple. Depends on the temperature, how much temperature we have to measure. Okay students, so this is first factor, transducer type. If you know which quantity you have to measure, then you have to decide the type of the transducer accordingly. Second important factor, transducer specifications. After selecting the group, that is transducer type, it also becomes essential to think about physical specification like size, package, type, diameter, height, and so on. Transducer selection also includes technical specification like operating range, temperature, sensitivity, graphical analysis, and minimum and maximum limitations, etc. For example, while designing a system for a temperature control or an automatic furnace control system, it is very important to know about minimum and maximum temperature that transducer can withstand where it is to be placed inside the furnace, so that the physical significance can be easily decided. In addition to these parameters, the graph is provided by manufacturer to get an idea of energy conversion in terms of sensitivity of transducer, how many signals can be generated by transducer, and so on. Means this is also most of the important factor while selecting transducer. So remember the transducer specification. By knowing this transducer specification, we can use proper type of specified transducer for conversion of energy. This is third factor while selecting the transducer, that is transducer compatibility. What is mean by compatibility? Means we have to decide the ability of transducer to convert one form of energy into another form. It must be considered that environmental conditions like temperature, acceleration, shock and vibration should not affect the accuracy of the instrument, and if they affect beyond certain limit, that then what technique is to be used to reduce their effects. The compatibility also includes other electrical properties like impedance matching. If there is no impedance matching, what will happen, students? Yes, loading effect. And if loading effect causes, then there is an error while measuring the electrical quantity or conversion of electrical quantity. So, we will not get the proper result. The compatibility also includes other electrical properties like impedance matching. So, this is impedance factor also important. Insulation, resistance and tolerance in sensitivity, so that the transducer performance becomes compatible with associated equipment system. These parameters help us while designing a system with maximum accuracy and to increase standard of the system by selecting correct transducer and associated system. Okay, students? So, this is also one of the most important factor while selecting transducer compatibility. Okay? So, remember, if the question arises like this, what factor should be considered while selecting the transducer? So, you have to explain these 3 points: transducer type, transducer specifications, transducer compatibility. Now, let's begin with different type of transducers. Now, this is capacitive transducer. This is passive type of transducer. So, this is also known as pressure transducer, where it detects small changes in pressure, and it can be called as a displacement transducer because it converts pressure into displacement and displacement into electrical signal. So, student, remember that this is a passive type of transducer. Okay? Now, let us see construction and principle of this passive capacitive transducer. Now, let us see in this diagram, this is capacitive transducer. This capacitive transducer constructed with the help of 2 parallel plates fixed in an insulating container. Out of these 2 plates, 1 plate is fixed, known as static plate, and other is movable membrane, known as diaphragm. This is the movable flexible plate. These 2 plates of an effective capacitor are separated by a dielectric. These 2 plates are separated with the distance D. An air pressure which is to be measured is applied to this diaphragm, as this is the movable flexible plate. Okay, so the name is given here, diaphragm. Now, basic principle of this capacitive transducer is that it works on the principle of capacitance produced by the displacement of one of the parallel plate. So, C is equal to epsilon A upon D, or C is directly proportional to 1 upon D. Means we can say that as this C is inversely proportional to the D, D is nothing but distance between these 2 plates. Students, remember that this capacitance C is inversely proportional to this D. Means as the distance between these plates goes on decreasing, this capacitance goes on increasing. And If this distance goes on increasing, the capacitance goes on decreasing. Okay, this C is capacitance of a transducer, A is area of each plate, epsilon, this is the dielectric constant of air, and this D, the distance between two parallel plates. Now let us see how this capacitive transducer works. When certain pressure is applied to the diaphragm, it changes its position and moves towards this static plate. Students, remember, this is a fixed plate. So this name is given here, static plate, and this diaphragm is movable membrane. Means when certain pressure is applied on the diaphragm, it changes its position and moves towards the static plate. Due to bending of diaphragm, the distance D between the plates get reduced. As we know that the distance is less, capacitance is maximum. Since the capacitance is inversely proportional to the distance of the capacitance of transducer increasing. As there is increase in the capacitance with decrease in the distance, that may cause electrical change in the circuit. Means it can be connected in oscillator circuit to produce change in the frequency when pressure is applied to it. So in this way, capacitive transducers can measure pressure by producing proportional displacement of its diaphragm, causing variations in capacitance. Now let us see advantages and disadvantages of capacitive transducer. It's easy to construct and having low price. It can be used to measure static and dynamic quantities. Its accuracy may be affected by temperature. It produces errors due to invisible capacitance produced by its long leads. So students, remember that this capacitive transducer is passive type of transducer. Okay, in this way you can draw the diagram and write the working with the help of this basic principle. Now let's see next transducer. This is second type of transducer. The name is thermistor. It is a passive type of transducer used to measure temperature. As it belongs to the passive category of transducer, it cannot generate self energy. So it requires external DC power supply to operate. Now what is the basic principle? This transducer changes its resistance with change in temperature. Basically, there are two types of thermistors, PTC and NTC. Now, what is meant by PTC? PTC means positive temperature coefficient of resistance, and negative temperature coefficient of resistance means NTC. As you can see this graph shows NTC type of thermistors. What is meant by NTC in this graph? As you can see, this is the resistance on y-axis, this temperature is on x-axis. As resistance goes on increasing, this temperature goes on decreasing in case of NTC. While in case of PTC, as resistance goes on increasing, so temperature also goes on increasing. Or we can say that as temperature goes on increasing, resistance also increases. But Instead of using PTC, NTC types are preferred because of its property. Means we can control any one quantity, either resistance or temperature. So, for this reason, thermistor, that is NTC type, can be preferred than PTC. You can see this is a symbol of thermistor. Thermistors are available in the market in different shapes and sizes, disc type, bead type, bulb type. In some cases, some thermistor it is available in washer type. Means, look at this diagram. These are the washer type of thermistors. These thermistors are very sensitive and widely used in industry for temperature measurement and in temperature control systems. As you can see, these are different type of shapes and packages are available in the market. This thermistor is composed of sintered mixture of metal oxide like manganese, nitrogen, cobalt, ferrous, uranium. They are available in such different packages, but bead type of thermistor is more popular. It has very small diameter, about 0.15 mm, with glass coated. And washer type and disc types are prepared by pressing thermistor material into flat shapes with diameter about 2.5 mm to 25 mm. Okay, students? Typical range of the thermistor is available from 0.5 ohm to 100 mega ohm, and temperature range is about 100 degrees Celsius to 300 degrees Celsius. Okay, students? Now, let us see this diagram. In this diagram, this is a thermistor connected with the combination of this bridge. This is a simple arrangement can be made to design an instrument like thermometer by using thermistor. Now, in this diagram, you can see this T is here, represent thermistor. With the combination of this R2, R3, R4, these all are the four resistor forms bridge called as a Wheatstone bridge. A thermistor can be connected in Wheatstone bridge circuit as shown in the figure. A galvanometer or micrometer can be placed across the bridge to show the deflection, where the current is flows or not. When the thermometer, this thermometer is not in use, the bridge is balanced condition. And when this bridge is in balanced condition, there is no current flows through the galvanometer. This galvanometer shows the zero deflection. Now, when patient's body temperature can be measured by simply putting this thermistor on patient's body so that the bridge becomes unbalanced. And when this bridge becomes unbalanced, the unbalanced bridge will produce current through this galvanometer. The deflection produced by this galvanometer is calibrated in terms of degree Celsius. Now, in this way, student, we can use this thermistor as an application to measure temperature in medical field or to measure patient's body temperature. Okay? Now, let us see another different type of application. Thermometer applications in medical instruments, temperature control soldering iron, flow meter or gas detector, furnace control, medical heating pad. In this way, these are the different type of applications of thermistor. So, the points remember in this topic, this thermistor is passive transducer. So, it requires external DC power supply, PTC type and NTC type of thermistor, एनटीसी मीन्स एज टेम्परेचर गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग रेजिस्टेंस गोज ऑन डिक्रीजिंग एंड पीटीसी एज द रेजिस्टेंस टेम्परेचर गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग रेजिस्टेंस ऑल्सो गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग. रेंज ऑफ दिस थर्मिस्टर विथ रेजिस्टेंस एंड टेम्परेचर एंड ऑल दीज आर एप्लीकेशंस. सो इन दिस वे इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड दैट वॉट इज मीन बाय ट्रांसड्यूसर, टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांसड्यूसर, वॉट फैक्टर शुड बी कंसिडर्ड वाइल सिलेक्टिंग ट्रांसड्यूसर्स एंड इन डिटेल द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द ट्रांसड्यूसर दैट इज कैपेसिटिव ट्रांसड्यूसर एंड दिस इज अ नेक्स्ट ट्रांसड्यूसर थर्मिस्टर. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, आई थिंक दिस इज इनफ फॉर टूडेज लेक्चर. इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर विल सी डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ ट्रांसड्यूसर. All the transducers are so simple, but you have to remember only diagram and basic principle. Okay, students? Thank you.